The awakening process prepares the body and the mind and the nervous system and all of the systems, emotional system, energy system, all of this here to embody truth, to be a living expression of our formless nature. And that is quite the process, and it involves a lot of healing and preparation. And so awakening itself is really powerful, and it can blast through a lot just on its own. A lot of content in the mind that's holding on, the contractions in the body, repressed emotions. It can work through a lot of what is stuck in the overall system. But often we need some support through awakening to help shift things along. And each person's journey with the healing component to awakening is going to be very different. Some people will need a lot, particularly if you've had a very hard life or a lot of early childhood trauma, or you have some issues such as an addiction or a mental illness. Then, of course, you're going to need more support on a healing level, but we all need some help. And I think it's helpful to understand how awakening works so you understand then what healing modalities would be appropriate. So I think we often start by healing the energy body, and we do this quite intuitively. Often, before awakening even starts, we have this feeling like we want to. Get Reiki or go to a shaman or get pranic healing or do something that helps the chakra system and the energy body. And we don't need to understand that or how that works, but there's often this is something that happens early on. And we can even get Kundalini activation that starts to shift things on an energetic level. So that can start, and we can also be on a physical level, have an intuitive sense that we're trying to get more healthy. And so this could look like just changing our diet, learning about natural medicine. It could be going to modalities such as like acupuncture or going to a chiropractor or getting massage or any one of those wonderful modalities that support either the energy body and the physical body, but there's like this preparation phase that seems to happen for a lot of people. And this is prior to awakening starting or in the early stages of awakening, where the body is getting prepared for what's about to come. And then that often shifts once there's a level of preparation there and a level of health there. So it's not about perfection. You don't need to be overly healthy for awakening to take place. It's just healthy enough so that you can get through the process. And this is where the truth will be embodied. It is in the body, in the flesh, in this nervous system. And so there needs to be some level of cleansing, purification, and emptying out, if that's probably good words as a pointer. And so whatever that looks like for you, but working towards, so on a bodily level, this could be qigong, it could be yoga, it could be mindful movement, letting the body go into poses that it feels intuitively wants to. It's not so important what the modality is, it's just understanding what it is that is trying to happen here, and then choosing something that feels right for you at that time, and then shifting and changing when it feels like you outgrow it. So doing something on a bodily level, on an energy level. So for me, I liked pranic healing. I found that to be very useful. I really enjoyed acupuncture, working on that level. And then there comes a stage where there's some psychological healing that will really start to become the focus. And so this is more along the lines of therapy, but I'm putting it in sort of the healing category. But we can say healing the psyche and healing the repressed emotions that are there and healing the nervous system. And so this can come later on in the awakening process, but at some stage, it moves to being really the focus and can go for many years, this part. And so this, I always recommend for this a modality called somatic experiencing, SE. So this is what I used, and I did it for about, I don't know, 3 or 4 years, maybe, very intensely though. And I just found it so beneficial for awakening because it works on a bodily level. And this is really important to understand with awakening, that it's not just about the mind and breaking free on that level. It's really about breaking free on all levels, emptying out on all levels, including the body. And so having a modality that also works on the mind as well to some degree, but is really focused on the body releasing what it couldn't during traumas that have happened, during difficult life events, which we've all had some, and allowing the fight flight response, allowing those contractions and those repressed emotions to come out, and that helps to regulate the nervous system. What happens then is that you can go deeper into your practices, deeper into meditation. You can rest more deeply in the nervous system. And this just helps awakening so much. The nervous system is such a key component to awakening. And so if you can't rest deeply because you've got trauma in the system, you're really going to not be able to make much progress. And that's really sad when I work with people and they see they've been seeking for even decades and they're not really getting anywhere. A lot of the time it's because their nervous system isn't regulated. And so a modality like SE really helps with that. But it is quite a challenging modality. I mean, it's a trauma therapy, so it's intense, certainly. And so it might not be the right time for you to do something that intense, and you might need to work towards that. So anything like a talk therapy or any type of therapies on the level of the mind would certainly be a step in the right direction towards that. But just understanding that we are looking for some type of modality that incorporates release on a bodily level and has a focus on the nervous system. And so another modality that I really love for the nervous system is craniosacral therapy. And this is less about releasing traumas, although that could come up, things in the body and contractions that can certainly be released and it can be very helpful for that. It's largely about the nervous system and helping with the regulation of that. And it's a hands-on modality, can kind of feel a little bit like energy healing, but it's more complex than that. And that can be a very supportive modality all the way through awakening. And it's also quite an enjoyable one. It's quite relaxing. There might be some emotions, of course, or things that arise, but often it's just a very deep, relaxed state. But if you're trying to understand what we're trying to do with awakening, the type of support that we need, although specific to each person. So if you have an addiction, then obviously see an addiction specialist. If you have a mental illness, that will be your pathway. Find someone that can understand that mental illness. If you have trauma in the system, you'll need assistance with that. So whatever it is that you're dealing with, find the best specialist that can help you with that specific thing, and that will form part of your awakening. If none of those things apply to you, then it's really about, is my nervous system regulating? Learn about the nervous system. I like Irene Lyon, Lyon. She's on YouTube. I like her content and how she explains the nervous system. And although this is sort of outside of awakening, it really does tie in, because to do the meditation practices and the self-inquiry practices and the embodiment practices, we really need to be in the body and have that body awareness and have that regulated, relaxed nervous system that's not in fight flight, so that all of the awakening process can work, all the processes can work, all the practices can work. It's really key and is such a block for people. So if you haven't made progress with awakening practices in a while, this could be something to look at, like learn about the nervous system, learn how it works and how you can help to regulate it. And so if you don't have the money for these modalities, there's a lot that you can do just by learning about how this works. Learning about how spending time in nature can help so much with healing the nervous system, how mindfulness practices of noticing what's in the room, just looking at a plant, patting your dog, really being here now, how these types of practices really help relax the nervous system. And so just learning a few little techniques like that can really help overall with awakening. And so we're really looking to work on all levels. So we're wanting a healing modality. So it's going to be multiple probably that you'll need that works on the level of the mind. So this will be more like therapy on the level of the mind, on the emotional system. So there's repressed emotions that we have stored, lodged in the system. So something that can help us to access that, all the blocked emotional content, and allow that to come out of the system. And then there's the physical body and what's trapped in the body, actually in the flesh, in the bones. There are things trapped in there. There's trauma trapped in there. There is patterns and contractions trapped actually in the body that wants to be released. So something that aids that, something that helps to support regulation of the nervous system. And so if we sort of understand we're working on all of these levels, and so we might need multiple healers, or we might need to be doing multiple healing practices ourselves, whatever we can find on YouTube, to support all of those different areas. But if we're coming at all of those different areas and we're doing practices to help relax, we're taking stress out of our life, we're making our life less complicated, we're learning how to spend lots of time out in nature and reconnect with not just such a wonderful teacher, a wonderful direct teacher that nature is, but also the healing capacity that it has that's just waiting for us right there, and just some simple mindfulness techniques that we can really overlook but can really be a game changer for awakening. So we can do things that are free just by educating ourselves, learning about how the nervous system works. And then if we have the money and we have the desire and the need, then taking it further and doing some sort of somatic experiencing or something along those lines. And I would say one way to look at awakening is that it's about healing everything, 100%. So if there was any type of goal with awakening, I would say that's what it is. And it's not necessary to have the first awakening, the first mind awakening shift. Each person will need to heal a different amount to get to that first hurdle. But overall, the path is healing 100%. That's where it's heading. And it's totally achievable. And the reason why it's achievable is because the awakening process itself supports the healing. They go together. So if you do a modality such as SE or craniosacral, and you're going through an awakening, it's amplified. The effect of the healing power of it is amplified, and it is quite amazing. So I managed to get through majority of my trauma, I'd say at least three quarters, in a 2-year period doing SE. And that was because I was going through an awakening. That's the power of awakening. So the two things combined, doing a modality that is the right one for you at the right time with the right practitioner that's a good match for you, and all of that, while also going through an awakening, you can do things that you really would never have believed how fast it can. And it doesn't make it any easier. It's certainly intense, and it's not like it's easy, but it can really blast through that karma, which for me, that's what it is. It's healing the karma, and it can really just go through the layers so much more quickly if you're going through an awakening. So that is one of the huge benefits to doing a healing modality while you are going through awakening, it really can do things that it's a quite miraculous, the speed that it can get through it. So I hope that makes you feel a bit better about the process and that it's not going to take forever. It's about finding the right modality. It's about being brave and going into those deep parts that you've been avoiding. When you're ready, when the nervous system is ready and having the right support and just facing them, and they literally will be gone for good. If you go deep enough, this is not about recycling the same content over and over again. If that's what's happening for you with whatever healing you're doing, then you're not going deep enough and the modality is not right for you. This is truly, when I say healing, I mean it's pulled up from the root and it's gone, never to be seen again. And it is permanent. I promise you, you can heal all of it, regardless of how hard your life has been. It is totally possible to heal all of your trauma, all of your karma, with the right support and with a bit of courage. So if there's a healing modality that you've used during awakening that you found particularly useful, I would really appreciate it if you put it in the comments below so that this can be a resource for other people that are watching this video, because this is, it's sometimes hard to find good help and the right modality on this path. So it can be helpful to have a list of different options.